Hi, my name is Freedom. Today I'm going to show you how to edit the texture of the cloth in CC3. This is the professional outfit. After I apply it, I should make it become a T-pose. You should find the T-pose here. Alright, like that is better. After that, double click your cloth, click here. This is a diffuse texture. We can direct edit here. Now, right click, click the UV references, click OK. I use the Adobe Photoshop, so I click this PC, C, program file, Adobe Photoshop, and double click the software. Now it will automatically open the UV mapping in Photoshop. Okay, so after that, here click. Okay, wait for a while. Still not finished loading. Now should be okay. Click select color range, then click here. Click OK. Press delete. Wait, this one should unlock it first. Okay. Click a new layer after that. Click the layer 0 after that. Press delete. We will just left this. These are the UV references. The next step, go to CC3, right click, click launch texture. So now actually you open it with a new tab. Now you have this and you have this. You can direct edit here and click save, but you don't have any references. So now I come here, click the layer 0. So click here, then click at the side. After that, here, Control A. Control A, to select everything, then Control C to copy. After that, go to the texture here. I open a okay. This one I unlock it. I drag the locker. See, drag the locker. Then I add a new layer. Should be at the top. Click the new layer. Then Control V. Now I can see the UV references. These are the mapping. We check. Alright. This one should be the front, and this one should be the back. Now I open a new layer. I try to add some words here. Can be just a simple scribble. I also can add some text here. Click text and add a text. Maybe if I want to add a name text, it'll be here. Insert text. Hello world. So now this one, make it bigger. Migrate this to home. After that, this UV references, I don't want already. I should make it unable to see. It is this part. This one, hide it. So now I want to export it. No, not export, I just save. File, save as. Here, choose PNG. Click save. Click OK. I should save in a special place. Save on my desktop. Wow, so messy. All this I don't want already. Cut. Later I will check it. All this I don't want. Okay. So this one I put on my desktop. File, save as. On the desktop, I choose PNG, click save. So now it become a PNG. After that, I also save the Photoshop file, the Adobe Photoshop file. The PSD also save on my desktop. Save. Okay. This is just save as a backup. Now back to my CC3. I want to replace this texture with a new texture. This one. So just to drag in. Now you see? Now I already add a new words here. Hello world. So this file, you can always come back to edit in the Photoshop. This is the UV references. It's for me to look, for me to see. And when save it as a PNG, you must make it invisible first. Export this. So the scribble, you also can hide it. Then you back to the original. So Adobe Photoshop is very useful. Editing. I also can create a new layer and just to simply scribble here. Some bloody scribble. It is up to you. You also can copy and paste some picture. Have a look. So this is the back. Okay. New layer, I open the references then, this is the back, I scribble at the front, some bloody scribble, here I can put some photos, example, Google something, maybe tiger. So if I want this, okay, so I want to capture Windows Shift S, capture the tiger face, and then back to my Photoshop here. Click this, Control V, and move it. Show transform to make it bigger. Wow, the tiger. Okay, so now I make this invisible. This one okay already. make it invisible. Now I can export it. Control Shift S is to Shift S. Now on my desktop, I save as the tiger, bar name, I put the tiger there, save as PNG, save, click OK. Now after that, I can back to my character creator. Now you look at the back, don't have any tiger. Now I put the tiger in. This new texture, drag in to replace it. The front is the bloody scribble, and the back is the tiger image. So now everything well done on this curve editing by using Adobe Photoshop. If you feel all this tutorial are helpful to you, you can subscribe to this channel and turn on the mini bell so that when next time I publish a new video, you receive the notification immediately. Thank you for watching. See you in my next video.